Greetings. The solution to the Korean problem is not diplomacy. The solution is a sincere and committed apology. Diplomacy implies negotiation as if nothing were wrong. But something is terribly wrong, and one party is grievously injured. To solve this problem, President Trump needs to openly discuss the history of the situation. A history that goes back to World War II. Not that far back. After World War II, two countries were divided in the settlement. Germany, who started the whole damn war, and you are free to consider the crushing economic penalties of World War I that drove them to it. And Korea, who was not even a combatant, not even in the Nazi Axis. Korea was conquered, and enslaved, and dominated by Japan. But sadly, after World War II, there were two powers driven for global dominance. One that at that time was actually a force for good, and one that was motivated by good in their own eyes. It was between these two powers that Korea suffered its worst fate. Division into two Koreas, North and South, as puppets no longer in control. After World War II, another conflict arose between the new North and South Koreas. The count of American dead is around 34,000 battle deaths, a tragic cost by any scale. The numbers for North Korea may be 90 times that. Some sources account for multiple millions. Just pause and think for a moment. How would you feel about a superpower that divided your nation and slaughtered millions? Lil' Kim wants nuclear weapons to balance the scale and prevent a repeat of the slaughter. We call him crazy, but is he crazy? I am not saying his murderous rise to power is cool and okay. But given the history, is their attitude toward another American invasion far-fetched? Or simply a bloated, bad, but real memory. Do not, for a moment, consider this an accusation of any kind against the U.S. soldiers who fought and died staunching communist expansion. Germany has been reunited. Why not open the subject for discussion? Reunify Korea. I make no pretense that the U.S. is pure as the driven snow. When trust has been destroyed, it must be re-earned. The free world should be appealing to North Korea, not punishing it. The solution to the Korean problem is not diplomacy. The solution is a sincere and committed apology. America, leading the free world, should approach Korea with support and opportunity. Proverbs 15:1, a gentle response diverts anger, but a harsh statement incites fury. For its part, North Korea must make the greatest self-sacrifice imaginable. Kim Jong-un must be willing to lay aside generational hatred for the sake of his people. If Kim Jong-un desired to be the greatest man in the history of his country, Korea, he must be willing to set aside his pride so that his people may live as a united Korea once more. Blessed are the peacemakers, for they will be called sons of God. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to his Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.